Hello students, today we are going to learn lesson number 5, articles in your English grammar book. Student, you might have learned them from a very young age. The use of a and the is being taught in this chapter. You know that articles can be of two types, indefinite and definite. Indefinite articles can be further classified as a and an. For basic terms, we know that A is used with consonant sound and N is used with a vowel sound. Here are some uses of the indefinite articles according to your book. First point is, before a noun which refers to any member of a group and not a specific member. Basically, if there is any thing which is countable and you can count it, then you can put a before it according to the sound they produce. When we have a word which starts with a vowel sound or gives you a vowel sound at the beginning, we use there the indefinite article n. Students, it is very easy to understand. For example, if we have to speak an example, I want to read a book. Book gives you the sound of a consonant, so we have put a there. If we use or if we speak like this, I want to eat an apple. Here apple is giving you a vowel sound, that's why we are putting the indefinite article n here. Let's move further and move to the definite article, that is the. So where do we use the? It is easy, before a specific noun, before a superlative adjective, any thing which is particular in its nature and one in its kind, before a noun that has been mentioned before, and there are many other usage which you can learn from your book as well. Later in the chapter, you have got second topic, that is omission of articles. Yes, students, sometimes we do not put articles or the articles are not needed in the sentence. How and when? Articles are omitted in a sentence in the following cases. Here are 7 cases which we are going to learn. First is when the singular noun represents all the people or things belonging to the particular class. Yes, students, if we have a group of thing, so we do not put any the or a before it. Next, we have before the names of material nouns from which things are made. Yes, this ring is made of gold. For example, this ring is made up of gold. So here before gold, we do not put the. If we add, this would make the sentence awkward. Next, we have with plural nouns representing the entire class. Again, if we have a group of people which are representing or which is representing a whole class or whole group, we do not put the over there. Then we have before the names of anything, like suppose my name is Samragi. If I use the before it, then it would be wrong. I am the Samragi. It is wrong. You cannot use the or definite article the before any person's name, disease, meals, days, months and seasons. Next we have before the names of languages and disciplines. For example, English is my favorite subject. You cannot put the Hindi is my favorite subject, the English is my favorite subject. It is totally wrong. Then we have while referring to one's relative, we do not put the before it. Like, for example, uncle promised to get me a copy of the book. If we use the uncle promised, that is wrong. Next we have in news headlines and notices. Yes, students, these headings or headlines are not complete or do not make complete sense on their own, and they are not grammatically correct sometimes also. That's why we do not put the before it. If the sentence requires, but it is not compulsory that we omit the in news headlines every time. The omission of article changes the meaning of the sentence sometimes. For example, the poet and the painter are no more. the poet and painter is no more. Here you have to revise the point which we have learned in subject and verb agreement. If the is being written before both the nouns, that means the persons are two in number. But if before the nouns we have only one the, that means it is referring to only one person. That's why in the first sentence we have put are after the subject and is in the second subject, in the second sentence after the subject. In the first sentence, the repetition of the definite article the indicates that the poet and the painter are two separate people. In the second sentence, the omission of the before the noun painter denotes that the poet and the painter refer to the same person. I hope that this chapter is clear to you and you are going to learn and practice articles at your home through our assignments and our study material. Thank you, students.